previously on Millennial Model Mayhem.
What about a crossover with nail art? That could be fun. And while you're here, you should do Barbie's nails.
Oh, guess what time it is?
That's right, we're doing the nail art crossover video.
What's up, people? My name is Liam, and welcome to the Millennial Model Mayhem Content Zone. Today, with the help of my spectral GF, Blue Parappa, we're going to combine the worlds of nail art and the Gunpla hobby to customize the greatest mobile suit of all time. The GOG. Why nail art? Well, just like how I noticed there's a lot of crossover between the miniature painting world and the Gunpla world, Blue Parappa noticed that there's a lot of terms that share similarities and cross over with the nail art world as well, so why not get creative with it?
It's free real estate.
I'll be taking care of the airbrushing part of the project, and Blue Parappa will be dealing with all the nail art aspects. So without further ado, let's get started on customizing this
thick,
bulbous mobile suit. Obviously, this model kit is very simple and fairly dated.
But there's just something about it that's so adorable, yet fierce, and also very budget-friendly. Those nails are just asking to be painted.
I agree. Now let's break it down and paint on the foundation for the nail art. I'm still working my way through the version 1 G-Paint, so to start, I'm priming everything with thinned Mr. Surfacer 1200.
For the arms and legs, I want them to be painted gunmetal. Then for the backpack and the knee joints, I was thinking you could mix up some darker iron, like you did before. The feet, inner headpiece, and kneecaps just need a base for the nail products, so they can just get painted black. Then for the main body, I want to maintain his one-piece swimsuit look, so can you paint it baby blue?
Sure thing. Since these panels are big and flat, I think this will be a good opportunity to try proper pre-shading. After painting a mix of white and blue over the black pre-shaded parts, I was disappointed in how little this shading showed through, so I thought, what the heck, I might as well try post-shading. And after mixing a little blue and black back into the baby blue mix to deepen the shadows, then going back to the baby blue with a bit of white added to reinforce the highlights, I was satisfied with the shaded armor pieces. Now it's your turn to shine, Blue Parappa.
Okay, well I should probably start by painting my nails. So after priming them with a China Glaze Strong Adhesion base coat, I do two coats of Revlon's Knockout shade, clean up my mistakes with nail polish remover combined with a clean-up brush and a Q-tip, then add some sparkle with Sally Hansen's Insta-Dry Grape Shifter.
You should probably paint my nails too.
Ah yes, the real moment I've been waiting for. Let's give you the same nail polish as the GOG, which is the Hypnotical Miracle Gel by Sally Hansen. After giving the GOG's iron nails two coats of Hypnotical, I did the same to the feet pieces because I wanted the fingers and the toes to match, of course. I tested most of these products out on some runners, and an SD New Gundam, before I started planning this GOG custom. It's been a pretty easy and fun way to customize kits so far. The only issues are that it's harder to achieve a smooth texture, has a longer drying time, and that nail top coat is not very effective. Next, I borrowed some of Liam's magenta paint and used this dotting tool to dot the mono eye. Now the most exciting part begins, which is to add some sparkly details. Using a toothpick, I apply a small amount of glossy top coat along the edge that I want to detail, then use a separate, slightly damp toothpick to pick up a single piece of glitter and stick it to the area with the top coat while it remains tacky. I also use this technique to place a larger glitter on the black knee pieces and a subtle pink glitter on the mono eye. Through my consumption of YouTube nail art content, I've noticed a lot of terminology that crosses over, like dry brushing, primer, top coat, using nail vinyls is similar to masking, and filing your nails is basically just sanding, but organic.
And just check out these other YouTubers. Mecha Gaikotsu has some Vampire the Masquerade looking goth nails, Brush for Hire has some vibrant nails to match his vibrant paint jobs, Guy from Midwinter Minis had that one Eldar painting video where he used nail art products, Dominic Noble has some fancy nails to go with his classy outfits, and you can even see Binging with Babish sporting some
polished fingies
in his latest videos.
Yes, I know, for high reason, technically a YouTuber, and Dominic Noble and Binging with Babish aren't making videos about mini painting or Gunpla. I'm just saying it's cool that I keep noticing content creators unexpectedly having painted nails, alright?
After asking Liam to seal in all that glitter with a glossy topcoat, I quickly filled in the details on the armor with a black panel liner and cleaned up with mineral spirits. Now, I think it's time. Nail up!
Great work, Blue Parappa. This is one dazzling mobile suit. Must have been tedious to place all that glitter.
Thanks. Couldn't have done it without you. I don't mind placing all that glitter, actually, but I do feel a little bad about some of the mistakes I can see.
That's okay. You had fun, right?
Of course. I love how the nail art gog turned out.
Here at Millennial Model Mayhem, we're committed to embracing our mistakes.
And
speaking of mistakes, I want to use some of these nail techniques to add a distraction to my Sengoku Ashtray's bad top coat. Going to use the same shifter paint that's on the swords in V-Fin to paint its nails. Shifter paint actually has a lot in common with iridescent nail polishes, but we'll talk more about shifter paints in the next video. I'm also going to use glitter to enhance these details. Now people won't know what to think when they look at this one.
There we go, the Nail Art Gunpla crossover project is complete.
Have we opened your mind to a whole new world of possibilities? Have you already been customizing your Gunpla with nail art, and we missed some crossover element, or you have a new technique you want to share? Have your jimmies become rustled by our foray into forbidden knowledge? Let us know in the comments section down below.
Like and share the video too.
Thanks for watching to the end of the video, and extra large thanks to Blue Parappa for once again collaborating with me and helping make this nail art project come to life. If you'd like to support my content creation endeavors, you can give me some free engagement here on YouTube or on my socials, or you can do some shopping through the affiliate links I have in the description, but by far the best way is to become a patron or YouTube member.
Or both.
Like these wonderful people. And of course, Janelle, member of the Gog Hand. Okay, it's time to get back to work on some other projects, so I'll see you again soon in the Hobby Content Zone.
The algorithm demands that you lock on notifications and annihilate the like and subscribe button!